Hello viewers, this is Dr. Hasanat, Associate Professor of Physiology from Ghazi Medical College, Khulna. Welcome back to my second lecture on physiological principle of electrocardiogram. Today, I will talk about the lead axis, normal cardiac axis, axis deviation, and the ECG patterns in the limb leads. Let's see. Actually, in a 12-lead ECG, there are three standard bipolar limb leads called lead 1, lead 2, lead 3. Here you can see that a positive electrode is attached to the left arm and another negative electrode that is attached to the right arm, and both the electrode they are connected to a galvanometer forming the circuit of the lead 1. So here is the left arm that is attached with positive electrode, and this is the right arm where the negative electrode is placed. Okay, and they are connected to a galvanometer forming the circuit of the lead 1, and the direction of the lead 1 is from right arm to the left arm. That means negative terminal to the positive terminal. Another important thing I want to mention, this positive terminal is also considered as the exploring electrode. Okay. Or camera eye, okay, exploring electrode. Okay, and here a parallel line is drawn along the lead 1 axis that passes across the center of the heart, and this indicates the axis of the lead 1. Okay. Now, in case of lead 2, the positive terminal is attached to the left foot or left leg, and the negative terminal is attached to the right arm, and both the terminal is connected to a galvanometer, okay, forming the circuit of the lead 2. And the direction of the lead 2 is from right arm to the left leg or left foot, that means downwards and to the left. And here is a line drawn parallel to the direction of the lead 2 that passes through the center of the heart, and this red line or red color arrow indicate the axis of the lead 2. Now the lead 3. In case of the lead 3, again the positive terminal is attached to the left foot and the negative terminal is attached to the left arm. And they are connected to a galvanometer forming the circuit of the lead 3. And their direction is from the left arm to the left leg or left foot. And a parallel line is drawn to the direction of the lead 3. And that line passes to the center of the heart, and that represents the axis of the lead 3. Okay. So this black color arrow that passes to the center of the heart represent the axis of the lead 1, that is from right to left, and this red color arrow that indicate the axis of the lead 2, and the direction is downwards and to the leftwards, and this violet color arrow indicates the axis of the lead 3, and the direction is downwards and to the rightwards. Okay. So actually these three leads around the heart, they forms a triangle. This triangle is called Enthoven triangles, where the heart is placed at the center of the of this triangle. Okay, so the next topic we should learn, that is, what is Enthoven triangle and what is Enthoven's law. So here is the triangle actually that is drawn around the heart, where the heart is placed at the center of this triangle, and each arm of this triangle represents the each lead of the bipolar limb lead. So what is Enthoven triangle? It is very simple. Enthoven triangle is an equilateral triangle with each side representing the axis of one of the bipolar limb leads, and where the heart is situated at the center of that triangle. This triangle is called Enthoven's triangle. Very simple. Now, this arrow indicates the direction of the mean QRS vector that is produced during the spread of the depolarizing current during the cardiac cycle. And this is also called the cardiac vector or cardiac axis. Now, if we draw a two perpendicular line on the lead one from the both end of the this cardiac vector, we will find the projected vector, okay, that forms on the lead one. So that is how we can get the projected vector for each lead. If we draw a perpendicular two perpendicular line from the head end of the cardiac axis and from the base on a particular lead, that will forms the projected vector for that lead. So in case of, say, this is a lead one and this is the projected vector, and the direction of the projected vector, that is towards the left, that means towards the positive terminal of the lead one. And you know, this positive terminal, it is the exploring electrode or I electrode. Okay, so when the positive current moves towards the positive terminal, that will produce a positive deflection. That is why in case of lead one, that will produce a positive QRS vector in the ECG paper. Okay. Now, for the lead two, this is the lead two that is formed between the right arm and the left leg or left foot. And this is the projected vector. This time, the projected vector, the direction of the projected vector, again, towards the left leg or left foot. That means toward the positive terminal of the lead two. That means the positive current moves towards the positive terminal. So what will happen? So lead two also produce a positive QRS wave in the ECG paper. Similarly, if we draw the projected vector for lead three, and that is also directed toward the positive terminal, that means towards the left leg. Okay, that means positive current moves towards the positive electrode. So lead three also produce the positive QRS in the ECG paper. One interesting thing you can observe here, that the voltage or height of the lead two, okay, that is the result of the summation of the voltage or potential of lead one and lead three. That means if you summed up the potential produced in the lead one and lead three, you will get the potential of lead 2. Okay. So that means lead 1 potential plus lead 3 potential is equal lead 2 potential. Because the lead 2 potential is the maximum, because the axis of the lead 2 and the cardiac axis, the direction is almost same. Okay. So that is actually Enthoven's law. So if there is if there is any variation or any deviation from the Enthoven's law, that indicates the electrodes are not correctly placed. Okay. Now the position of the exploring electrode or exploring eye. For understanding the position of the exploring electrode, suppose this is a clock. Okay. So this is the center of the clock, and across the center there is horizontal line. This is considered as 0 degree, okay, or zero potential, this horizontal line. And if you rotate clockwise, okay. And another thing I want to mention, this is the position of 3 o'clock position. 3 o'clock position, that means that is situated along the horizontal axis, and this 3 o'clock position is considered as 0 degree. So now if you rotate clockwise, then 4 o'clock, it will represent the plus 30 degree. 5 o'clock, that represent plus 60 degree. That means 0 degree, 30 degree, 60 degree, that is 30 degree interval. Then if this is 5 o'clock position, so 6 o'clock position, that indicates plus 90 degree. 7 o'clock position, that indicates plus 120 degree. 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock means plus 150 degree, and 9 o'clock, that forms a 180 degree angle. Okay. And if you add, this is 9 o'clock, if this is 10 o'clock, then add another 30 degree, that means 210 degree. So this is clockwise. And if you calculate anti-clockwise, then this is, say, this is 3 o'clock means 0 degree. So 2 o'clock position, that means minus 30 degree. 1 o'clock position means minus 60 degree. 12 o'clock position means minus 90 degree. Okay. And 11 o'clock position means minus 120 degree. Okay. Now, here is the position of the different limb, lead. So if we draw the parallel line through the center of the heart to the direction of the lead one, that will indicate the axis of the lead one. Here the B, vector B, that indicate the axis of the lead one. Okay, that means from left to right. And in case of lead one, this is the, on the left side, that is the positive terminal or position of the exploring electrode in case of lead one. So this is actually indicate, this is 3 o'clock position, that means 0 degree. So here is the 0 degree, the horizontal plane. Okay. Now in case of lead 2, that is, here is the position of the exploring electrode or the positive electrode. So if it is 0 degree, 3 o'clock position, so 4 o'clock means plus 30 degree, 5 o'clock means plus 60 degree. So this is the position of 5 o'clock, that means plus 60 degree. So the position of the exploring electrode in case of lead 2, it is plus 60 degree. Okay. Okay, fine. Now I want to use an indicator. Spotlight. Okay. Now, in case of, this is the lead 3, that is drawn parallel to the direction of the lead 3 and passing to the center of the heart. So this is this indicate the direction of the lead 3, and the position is 7 o'clock position, that means plus 120 degree. Okay, so this is the 120 degree. So now, is it clear to you what is the different position of the exploring electrode of the bipolar limb leads? Lead, in case of lead 1, the position of the exploring electrode is the 0 degree. In case of lead 2, it is situated at the 5 o'clock position or plus 60 degree. And the position of the exploring electrode of lead 3, that is situated at the 7 o'clock position, that means 120 degree angle. Okay. So you can easily calculate the angle. Just imagine a clock. Okay. 3 o'clock means 0 degree. 4 o'clock means plus 30 degree. 5 o'clock means plus 60 degree. 6 o'clock means plus 90 degree. 7 o'clock means plus 120 degree. That means 30 degree interval. Now, the electrical axis of the 3 standard limb lead, just I have explained. So, in case of lead 1, the negative terminal is attached with the right arm and the positive terminal is attached with the left arm. So the electrical axis of the lead 1 from right to the left in the horizontal plane, and the position of the exploring electrode in case of lead 1, that is 0 degree. Similarly, in case of lead 2, the negative terminal is attached to the right arm and the positive terminal is attached to the left leg. So the electrical axis of lead 2 is from above downwards and slightly towards the left. And the position of the exploring electrode, it is actually 5 o'clock position. It's 5 o'clock position, that means plus 60 degree. And in case of lead 3, the negative terminal or electrode is placed on the left arm and the positive electrode is placed on the left leg. So the electrical axis of lead 3 from above downwards and slightly towards the right. And the position of the exploring electrode in case of lead 3, that is at the 7 o'clock position, that means plus 120 degree. So these are the different angle from which this exploring electrode, they will record the electrical picture of the heart. Now, the cardiac axis. What is cardiac axis? I have explained it in the first lecture that the direction of the mean QRS vector during the spread of depolarizing current throughout the heart that represent the cardiac axis. Okay, and the direction of that vector is from base to apex, that means downwards and to the leftwards. So in a normal heart, the average direction of the vector during spread of depolarization wave through the ventricle called the mean QRS vector, and that is directed downward and to leftward, and it forms a plus 59 degree to the axis of the lead on or to the horizontal plane. Okay, and that is called the normal cardiac axis. Actually plus 59 degree, it is the average measurement. Okay, but it may vary between minus 30 degree to plus 90 degree. That will be normal cardiac axis, but average it is plus 59 degree. So in this picture, here is the mean QRS vector. You can see this A vector represent the cardiac vector or cardiac axis. Okay, that is directed towards directed to downwards and to the left, and that forms a plus 59 degree angle to the horizontal axis. So that is why this is called cardiac axis. Okay. One thing I want to mention here, when the cardiac axis forms an angle to a particular lead more than 90 degrees. More than 90 degrees. That will produce a negative deflection on that particular lead. But if the angle between the cardiac axis and with the particular lead axis is less than 90 degrees, that particular lead will produce a positive QRS in the ECG paper. So this is a very basic thing. Basic thing. Another thing I want to mention that when the cardiac axis is close to a particular lead axis, the voltage on that lead will increase, and that will increase the height of that wave. And when it is going far from the, when the cardiac axis or lead axis, the distance is increasing, gradually the voltage on that lead or height of the wave on that particular lead will gradually decrease. So cardiac axis, in case of when the cardiac axis is more closer towards the lead axis, it will increase the voltage and height of the wave. So when the cardiac axis is going far, okay, and that will gradually decrease the voltage or height of that wave in the ECG paper. This is the very basic thing. Now, say this is a mean QRS vector, and that is directed downwards and to the left. So this is the normal cardiac axis. Say this is the three different limb leads, lead 1, lead 2, lead 3, and this represent the direction of the cardiac axis. So if you draw the projected vector for lead 1, you will get the direction of that projected vector is towards the left. And in case of lead 1, the left arm, there is actually the positive terminal. So the positive current, when moves towards the positive terminal, that will produce a positive deflection. So in case of normal cardiac axis, lead 1 produce positive QRS in the ECG paper. Here is the positive QRS. So lead 1 produce positive QRS. Okay. Now let's see, what about the lead 2? In case of lead 2, if you draw the projected vector, you will get that the direction of this projected vector is towards the left leg. So in case of lead 2, the positive electrode is situated on the left leg. That means the vector is directed to the exploring electrode. So again, this lead 2 also produce the positive QRS in the ECG paper. And the voltage, it is maximum in the lead 2 because the direction of the cardiac vector and the direction of the projected vector, this is almost same, or lead axis and the axis of the cardiac axis, it is almost same. That is why the voltage is maximum. Okay, now similarly, in case of lead 3, the direction of this projected vector again towards the left leg, that means towards the positive terminal. So that means lead 3 also produce the positive QRS in the ECG paper. That means in case of normal cardiac axis, you will find a positive QRS in all the three bipolar limb leads. Okay, that is, that indicates the cardiac axis is normal. If all the QRS wave is positive in all the bipolar limb lead. Now let's see what will happen if the, due to any pathology, I will discuss it in the later classes, but this time there's a very basic thing. Say due to any reason, this normal cardiac axis, that is say it deviates towards the right, tilted toward the right side, what will happen? Now say this is the cardiac axis and that is deviate towards the right. Now if you draw the projected vector on the lead 1, we'll find this time the direction of the projected vector is completely opposite from the first case. Okay, and this time the direction of this vector towards the left to right, that means towards the negative terminal, that means away from the positive terminal or away from the exploring electrode. So what will happen? The lead one will produce a negative QRS in the ECG paper. But in case of lead two, this is the lead two. So if this projected vector is directed towards the positive terminal, okay. So lead two will produce positive QRS in the ECG paper. And lead three, similarly lead three, that this projected vector is also directed toward the positive electrode. So again, lead three also produce the positive QRS in the lead three. That means in case of right axis deviation, the lead one produce a negative QRS, okay? But the remaining two, they will produce a positive QRS. That indicates right axis deviation. Now, another thing, so what will happen in case of left axis deviation? This time, the axis is deviated to the left. So, if we draw the projected vector on lead one, that is directed toward the positive terminal of the lead one, that means that will produce a positive QRS in the lead one. In case of lead two, the direction of the projected vector is also towards the positive terminal. So that will also produce the positive QRS in the lead two. And in case of lead three, this time, this in case of lead three, the direction of the projected vector, that is towards the negative terminal, because we know in case of lead three, the positive terminal is attached to the left leg. So this direction is away from the positive terminal. That means away from the exploring electrode. That means this lead three will produce a negative QRS in the ECG paper. That means in case of left axis deviation, you will find find the positive QRS in the lead one, lead two, but a negative QRS in the lead three. Okay, so the picture is like that: lead one positive QRS, lead two positive QRS, but the lead three, it will produce the negative QRS in the ECG paper, and that indicates left axis deviation. That is how we can get the cardiac axis. If the all the lead produce a positive QRS, that means normal cardiac axis. If the lead one is negative QRS, but lead three is positive, that means right axis deviation. And if the lead one is positive, but the lead three is negative, that indicates left axis deviations. So that's all about bipolar limb leads. Now, scientists, they want to focus the more areas of the heart so that they introduce the three new leads. Okay, so that the more area of the heart can be covered. What are those? There are another three leads. They are called augmented unipolar limb leads. They are also limb leads, but they are unipolar. Okay. And augmented, they are called AVR, AVL, and AVF. Actually, V stands for the unipolar. R, L, F indicate the exploring or active electrode is on the, R means right arm, L for left arm, and F for left foot or left leg, respectively. Okay. And A stands for augmentation. Actually, this unipolar VR, VL, and VF, they produce very low voltage in the ECG paper. So, for the amplification or augmentation of the voltage of these three leads, there are other electrodes that are attached to this three lead, and that electrodes are called indifferent electrode. But the point is, this indifferent electrode is connected to the remaining two leads through a resistance coil. That means they remain inactive. Okay, but this AVR, AVL, and AVF, the active electrode, they are actually positive. Okay, but they are also connected to a negative terminal, and they are called indifferent electrode. Okay, but they are connected to a galvanometer with a high resistance coil so that they remain active, but they can augment the recording of the VR, VL, and VF. That is why these three leads are called augmented unipolar limb leads. Is it clear? Okay. As for example, for recording of the AVL, AVL means left arm. Okay, augmented limb leads that is inserted in the left arm or left shoulder. Okay. The active electrode is placed on the left arm or left shoulder, and the indifferent electrode, that are negative terminal, is connected through a high resistance to the other two electrodes placed on the left foot and right arm. But these two or indifferent electrode, that is negative terminal, they remain inactive, but they can augment the recording of the AVL. Okay, VL, that is why they are called augmented unipolar limb leads. So now the axis of the AVR, AVL, and AVF, or position of the exploring electrode in case of AVR, AVL, and AVF. So here you can see, so this is the heart, and say if you suppose it is a clock and heart is located at the center of this clock. So at the 0 degree position, that is the position of the lead one. Okay. Actually, AVF is placed between the lead 2 and lead 3. You know, the lead 2, the position of the exploring electrode, it is 60 degree. And in case of lead 3, the position of the exploring electrode, it is 120 degree. 60 degree means 5 o'clock, and 1 plus 120 degree means 7 o'clock position. AVF, the lead AVF, that is actually situated between these two leads. That means it is 6 o'clock position. That means plus 90 degree from the axis of the lead on, or horizontal axis. This is plus 90 degree. So the position of the AVF or exploring electrode of AVF, that is plus 90 degree. And AVF can focus directly, they are looking directly at the inferior surface of the heart. Okay, they can record the electrical activity that occurs in the inferior surface of the heart. Okay. Now, AVL. AVL, that is means left arm or left shoulder. Okay. And the position of the AVL, that is actually, if this is 0 degree means 3 o'clock position, so this is 2 o'clock position means minus 30 degree. 2 o'clock position. Okay, that means minus 30 degree. So why it is minus? Because this time it is anti-clockwise. If you go clockwise, then it will be positive. Okay, then that means 4 o'clock positions means plus 30 degree. 3 o'clock, it is horizontal axis, so it is 0 degree. But 2 o'clock position, that is minus 30 degree. Okay. So the position of the AVL, it is minus 30 degree. And the position of the AVR, that is, it is actually, if you count anti-clockwise, say 2 o'clock means minus 30 degree, 1 o'clock means minus 60 degree. 12 o'clock means minus 90 degree. 11 o'clock means minus 120 degree. Okay. And 10 o'clock means minus 150 degree. But if you count clockwise, say this is 6 o'clock means 90 degree. 7 o'clock, 120. 8 o'clock, 210. Sorry. 90 degree, 120. This is 8 o'clock, 150. And 9 o'clock means 180. Yeah, 9 and 10 o'clock means 210 degree. So you can see here the more clearly. So that is the position of the exploring electrode of the unipolar limb lead. AVR, AVL, AVF. So here is the AVF. It is situated at the 6 o'clock position on 90 degree angle, and they can focus the inferior surface of the heart. Okay. And AVR, that is located at the 10 o'clock position. That means clockwise it is plus 210 degree, but if you count anti-clockwise, that is minus 150 degree angle. And AVR actually focus towards the right atrium of the heart. So they can record the electrical activity of the right atrium. And AVL, they are situated at the 2 o'clock position, that means minus 30 degree, and they can record the electrical activity of the left atrium of the heart. Okay. Now, listen carefully. If you see or observe carefully that lead 2, lead 3 and AVF, these three lead together, they are focusing the inferior surface of the heart. So they can record the electrical picture from the inferior surface of the heart. Okay. And AVR, they record the electrical activity of the right atrium. AVL, they record the electrical activity of the left atrium. And together, AVL, lead 1 and lead 2, they can record the electrical activity of the left lateral surface of the heart. Okay, this is the very basic concept. This is, it will be very helpful during the interpretation of the ECG. That will be discussed in the later classes during the discussion of the pathological changes in different leads. Okay, so these leads are nothing. They are actually camera. Or exploring eye or exploring electrode that are situated at different angle from the heart, and they can record the electrical picture of the heart from the different angle. Okay, so this is the AVL. The angle is, it is 2 o'clock position, that means minus 30. This is the lead 1 camera or exploring electrode that is situated at the 0 degree. And this is the lead 2 camera or exploring electrode of the lead 2 that is situated at 60 degree, plus 60 degree. AVF directly focus the inferior surface from the plus 90 degree. And then lead 3 plus 120 degree. Okay. And the AVR, that the angle is plus 210 degree for clockwise, or if you count anti-clockwise, that is minus 150 degree. So that is the position of exploring electrode of the different limb leads. So how many limb leads are there? There are 6 limb leads. 3 of them are bipolar limb leads, and the remaining 3 are called unipolar, augmented unipolar limb leads. Okay. And this is the actually mean cardiac vector, also called the cardiac axis, that is produced by the depolarizing current that is spread during the cardiac cycle. That is called cardiac axis, and that should be situated between the minus 30 degree to plus 90 degree if it is normal. But if this cardiac axis deviates, either it may deviate from the left side or it may deviate to the right side and causes left axis deviation or right axis deviation. So this 6 picture of the axis of leads in the frontal plane is called hexaxial reference system, because the six exploring electrodes, they are recording the electrical activity along the frontal plane. Frontal planes means longitudinal and the horizontal, right to left. Okay. So, what will be the pattern that is produced in the AVR, AVL and AVF? Say, this is the normal cardiac vector or cardiac axis, and that is the position of the AVL, that is 2 o'clock or minus 30 degree. So angle between this AVL and the cardiac axis, that is almost 90 degree. In the first class, I have mentioned when there is a formation of 90 degree angle between the cardiac axis and the axis of the particular lead. So that particular lead will produce a biphasic deflections. Okay, that means normally this AVL, that will produce the biphasic deflection in the ECG paper. If the cardiac axis is situated, if the cardiac axis is situated at the plus 59, average plus 59 degree angle. Now, this is the AVF and this is the projected vector for AVF. So the direction is toward the AVF. So definitely AVF will produce a positive QRS. Okay, and as the, okay, now for AVR, here you can see the direction of the AVR, that is completely reverse to the direction of the cardiac axis. That means definitely AVR will produce negative QRS in the ECG paper. So that is the normal pattern of ECG recording in the this augmented unipolar limb lead in the AVR. AVR will produce always negative because their direction is completely opposite to the cardiac vector. Okay. So AVF, it will produce positive deflection, and the amplitude or voltage of the AVF is the maximum among these three leads because it is more close. Cardiac axis is more close to the AVF. That is why the voltage is maximum here. Okay. But if the axis is deviate, then it will the voltage will vary. Is it clear? And the lead, in case of AVL, the lead axis and the cardiac axis, there is a 90 degree angle. That is why there will be a biphasic deflection. If the lead is deviate to the left, then in that situation, in case of AVL, in the AVL, the voltage will increase, but in the AVF, voltage will decrease. Okay. Okay, fine. So the normal card axis ranges from minus 30 degree to plus 90 degree range. Some books also mention the normal axis is between 0 degree to plus 90 degree range. So here is the position of the exploring electrode of different limb leads. Okay. And here is this red color arrow indicates the cardiac axis that is directed towards, directed to downwards and to the leftwards. So if this axis is situated between this minus 30 degree to plus 90 degree, then it is considered the cardiac axis is normal. Okay. But if it's deviate to the left beyond the minus 30 degree, that will cause left axis deviation. And if the cardiac axis deviates to the right side beyond the plus 90 degree, that will cause right axis deviation, RAD, right axis deviation. Okay. So minus 30 to plus 90 degree, it is normal axis. But it is deviate to the left beyond the minus 30 degree, this is LAD, that means left axis deviation. And if it's deviate to the right beyond the plus 90 degree, then it will then it is called right axis deviation or RAD. So if they say if the axis is normal, that means say here is the normal axis. So the lead one will produce, if you draw the projected vector on the lead one, we'll find the projected vector that will be directed towards the positive terminal. So lead one will be positive. Okay. And in case of lead two, that is also positive because the direction of the lead two and the direction of the cardiac axis is almost similar. That is why the voltage is also more in case of lead two. Okay. And if you consider the unipolar limb length, AVF, if the cardiac axis is normal, so the AVF also, it will also produce a positive QRS in the ECG paper. So that means if you check, if you find the lead one positive or lead two positive or lead one and lead AVF positive, that means the cardiac axis is normal. Okay. Now, what will happen in case of right axis deviation? So this is the cardiac vector or cardiac axis that is deviates to the right side. That means this is the right axis deviation. When the cardiac axis deviates beyond the plus 90 degree, so the new vector, new cardiac vector that is deviate to this position. Okay. So now what will happen? What will happen to lead one? Here you can see the angle between lead one and the cardiac axis is more than 90 degree. So in the early period of my today's lecture, I have mentioned when the angle between the lead axis and the cardiac axis is more than 90 degree, that particular lead will produce a negative QRS in the ECG lead. So this time the cardiac axis and the lead one direction, the angle is formed that is more than 90 degree. So the lead one will produce a negative QRS. But in case of lead three, so if you draw the projected vector for lead three, you will find the projected vector is directed towards the positive electrode or the exploring electrode. Okay, and this time this cardiac axis is very close to lead 3. That is why lead 3 is positive and the voltage is maximum in the lead 3. Okay, so in case of right axis deviation, the voltage in the lead 3, it will be increased. So in case of right axis deviation, the most important findings, the lead one produced the negative QRS, but the lead three will produce positive and the voltage in the lead three, it will increase. But AVF, in case of right axis deviation, say if you draw the projected vector for AVF, you'll find that direction of the projected vector toward the exploring electrode of the AVF or toward the positive electrode. So it will produce the positive QRS in the ECG paper. Okay. So in case of right axis deviation, AVF also remain positive. Now the left axis deviation. So here the cardiac axis is deviate towards the left. So what will happen? Say now this is the position of the cardiac vector or cardiac axis. So what will happen to lead one? So the angle between the lead one is cardiac axis is less than 90. That means it will produce positive deflections. Okay. But what happened to lead three? Now see carefully. The angle between cardiac axis and the lead three axis, that is more than 90 degree and almost the direction is opposite. Okay, so that will produce a very big negative QRS in the ECG paper. So in case of left axis deviation, you will find the positive QRS in the lead one, but the negative QRS in the lead three. You will also find the negative QRS in the AVF. So this is the axis of the AVF. So here is the axis of the cardiac axis. Once again, the angle between cardiac axis and the lead axis of AVF is more than 90 degrees. So that will produce a negative deflections. So if you find if lead one is positive, you also check the AVF. If the AVF is negative, lead three negative, that means definitely it is a left axis deviation. So that is enough for today. So my next lecture will be about the chest lift. Okay. And if you like my video, then don't forget to subscribe my channel and please share with your friends. Stay connected. Thank you very much.